A little pick-me-up.
Quartermain?
Mm-hmm. Sir, something urgent. Patient number 621 is roaming about the halls yet again.
You wake me up for that?
Don't you think it's time we finally did something about 621?
Like what?
We can't just have him roam about the halls and do whatever he pleases. We have to control him.
Quartermain, at this point, I think it's obvious there is no way to control him.
So, you're going to do nothing? And just let him play doctor with the other patients?
Yeah.
Well then, let's see. Who shall we pick? Who will be the lucky patient to receive my miraculous treatment? Decisions. Ah, Mr. DeWitt, the ghostwriter. Working on another masterpiece, no doubt. Sweet Miss Cranston, the Purple Dragon. Ever the romantic, I see. Mr. Oxtifer, good old Bosspire, the mob leader who thinks he's a vampire. Now there's a fascinating case. Howdy, Vlad. Looking for Bram Stoker's Dracula?
Go away, insect.
Now, I'm here to help. Through my radical therapy technique, you'll never fear the sun or garlic ever again.
If you don't go away, I'll have my boys drain you of all your blood.
Maybe some other time, then. The lovely Miss Dahli, the Black Widow. Now there's a challenge. The serial killer who sleeps with men, then kills them and eats them. She believes this is the only way she can feed. And all because her uncle sexually abused her, refused to feed her, and locked her up in an attic full of Black Widow spiders. Truly a tough case. Not even Wickman himself has made any progress with her. I do believe we have a winner.
I see we're finally awake. Perhaps forcing her to face her fears was the wrong approach. Plan B. I see we're awake again.
What's going on? Where are we?
We have left home for a little field trip, Miss Dahli. Part of your therapy.
What are you talking about? Wait a minute. I know you. I've seen you before at Hillbrook.
I am your new doctor, Miss Dahli. And I am here to do what Wickman failed. Cure you of your mad ways.
Now hold up, Sugar Pie. Can't that wait? Let's get better acquainted first.
Sorry, Miss Dahli, but your charms don't work on me. I'm a man of the mind, not the flesh. I have no interest in your buxom frame, and certainly no interest in becoming your next meal. I'm here to put a stop to those eating habits of yours. After I'm through with you, you'll never nibble on another human leg again.
Mm-hmm, but what if I took off these clothes right in front of you?
Enough nonsense, Miss Dahli. We've got work to do. We're going out for dinner. There's clothes in the bathroom for you. Put them on.
What kind of clothes are these?
Well, we need to tone down your sexuality, hmm?
I'm not so sure about this. I can't eat this kind of food.
Don't worry. This is the best restaurant in town. You have to give it a shot, at least. Don't you want to get better?
Of course I do.
Well then, chop down on those noodles instead of a human liver.
Isn't there another way? You know. Come on, Doc. We could go back to that hotel room and...
Knock that off. Now eat.
It's horrible.
Okay, so that didn't go so well either. But don't worry, I've got another idea.
No! I've had it with you!
Hold on!
Oh. Rough day, buddy?
Understatement of the year.
Hello there, handsome. Are you alone tonight?
Yeah.
Well, not any longer, honey. I'm looking for some fun. Are you up for it?
Well, sure.
Well, then let's ditch this joint. You got a place nearby?
No, but I know of a hotel a couple of blocks away.
Excellent.
Miss, you just saved my day. You first, gorgeous.
Such a gentleman. I'm famished.
Stop!
Who the hell are you? Her dad or something?
Mister, you don't know who she is and what she's capable of. Trust me, I'm a doctor.
What are you on about? Get out of here!
No, you get out of here!
Lay off!
Enough already.
I'm very disappointed in you, Lillian. After all the help I've tried to give you, only for you to fall back on your own ways. Don't you want to get better?
Of course I do. Do you think I want to eat people? But I've tried eating regular food and it just doesn't work. And I'm so hungry.
Perhaps I bit off more than I could chew. Maybe it's time to go home, Lillian.
What should I do with you?
Give me a raise?
Have you learned your lesson now? That you should leave the therapy to the professionals?
Oh, dear old Quinty, how can you speak to your colleague like that? Sure, I failed Miss Dahli, but there are plenty others I can help. I may have lost this battle, but not the war. No, it wages on, and I am at the front line. This place needs me, and I will never give it up.
Like the stars in the sky, to be just a little glimmer of light.